Good morning, students. Today I am explaining about C++ functions and its parts. So what is a function? In the first unit we have one chapter called, in the first semester already we have the functions, and the second semester also we have the concept functions. What is a function? A function means a self-contained block of statements. Self-contained block of statements to perform particular task. Clear? A function having a function name, that is the return type. Return type function name inside brackets there is arguments and a block. This is called as a function body. Here this is the return type. It is the name, whatever name we are identified the entire body of the function. These are the arguments of the values we are passing to the function. So return type, function name and arguments, body of the function. So in C++ there are two types of functions are there. What are those? Library functions and another one is user defined functions and library functions. Library means those functions are already predefined. These functions are already predefined. There is no need of definitions. Already someone, the developers already these functions are defined. Only we are, whenever it is that required, then only we are directly accessing. There is no need of again defining these functions. For example, if you want to find square root, so we don't have square root symbol. Directly you can use the sqrt function. Already it is defined. How to find the square root already defined in the C++ library. So directly you can use sqrt of 4, automatically the square root will be displayed. But where it is defined, already it is defined in the C++ library. There is no need, don't worry about the definition. Already these functions are defined. Those are our string functions. Whatever functions we are using in our program, those all are predefined. And coming to your required purpose, you can write your own functions. Those functions are user defined functions. These functions, when we are writing any function, what parts are required? The user defined or library functions, the some parts are required. Any, if you want to write any program, so what is required? The body of the function is required, function name is required, arguments is required, return type is required. These all are called the various parts of function. What it is? Function declaration. Another one is function definition. And another one is naming a function. And function arguments. If whatever the values you are sending, those are called as function arguments. Or these are also called as function parameters. Clear? And return type of the function. Return type. In this return type, there is a void keyword also we are using. Void functions also we are using. And another one is a recursive function. Recursive function or function recursion. So these are the various parts we are used in defining any function. If you want to write any function, what is required? Function declaration is required, function body is required. If you want to write any block of statements, a self-contained block of statements is a function. That entire block can be identified by a function name. So some values we are sending to the function declaration to function definition, those are called as function arguments or parameters. So function returns again back to the sum value, that is called return type. What value it again returns to the back, that is called return type. Function doesn't return any value, that is called void function. A function can be declared inside the another function, the same function. A function, that is called function, calls itself. Another function is called as a function, recursive function. That function is called as a recursive function. For example, what, how these all parts we are have defining. For example, I am declaring one function, integer, integer sum of int x comma int y. Sum of int x comma int y. Here I am declared another variable int z. Z equals to x plus y return z. Clearly observe. So first of all, function declaration means where this function is called. In the main, for example, I am writing one void main. In the main, I declared sum of, I want sum of 10 comma 20. Here I am using the same function name, sum of 10 comma 20. How to find sum? This is a function. When I am using this function, this body of the function is required. This is called function declared here. So function definition, where about this sum, where I defined, that is called definition of the function. This is called the function definition. Here I am defined. This is called body of the function is we are defined. What is the meaning of sum? That is defined here. And naming a function, this is I am used for adding of two numbers. That's why I am given name for the function is called sum. And function arguments, here I am sending 10 and 20. The 10 and 20 received by x and y. These are the formal arguments. These are the formal arguments. These are the actual arguments. The values I am, when I am sending, those are comes to the x and y. These are called as arguments or parameters. And coming to next one, return type. Here I am returning value. What value I am returning? Z. Z means what? It is integer. That's why you can give here the return type as integer. If I am not returning any value, simply you can give mention here void. Clear. So again, in the function only I am using sum. Sum of 20 comma 40. A function itself, another function, that is called recursive function. In this way we are defining functions. These are the function parts. Once again, listen, function means self-contained block of statements. It can be used to perform a state. This is a self-contained block of statements. So this perform a particular task, what it is, adding of two numbers. The task is adding of two numbers. If you want to, there are two types of functions. One is library functions. Those are called predefined. Already this is developed by C developers. If you want to write your own functions, what it is needed, those are called function parts. Function declaration is required, function definition is required, naming a function is required, function arguments are required, return type of a function is required, recursive function. So it is the function declaration, this is the function definition, this is name of the function, these are the arguments of the function, this is body of the function, it is the return type of the function, it is the return of the function. Clear? This is about the functions. Again, I will explain briefly in the next class.